The visual memory unit. Very innovative. A plug-in device for your Dreamcast controller. You can save games to it. You can upload games from retail games to it, little mini games. Sega Visual Memory Unit tells the time too. The Dreamcast, powered by Power VR graphics, 128-bit power, four control ports, 56K internal modem, optional Ethernet modem. This is Sega's Dreamcast. Windows CE compatible. Enjoy the video. That's the spinning Dreamcast logo. So here is the Dreamcast's built-in UI. We got play, file, music and settings. As you can see, if we go into file, it gives us a file manager for our visual memory unit or our memory card. Settings, we can change the clock and things like that. This particular Dreamcast has a dead CR2032 battery, so it doesn't keep the time, unfortunately. I haven't got round to sorting of it. So there's the Dreamcast boot screen. Let's play on the first game, shall we? So this is... Are you ready? Here it comes. Ready or not? Gauntlet Legends is our first choice today. So this is Gauntlet Legends on the Dreamcast. Start the game. Let's have a look in options first. Change the difficulty to easy, I think. So here is Gauntlet Legends.
Enter initials to build a character.
So I've got to enter my initials to build a character. No, I do. It's not quite there, but there you go. Now I can choose my character, as you can see. I'll be the Yellow Warrior. Yeah, we all remember Gauntlet on the old arcade machine and the old 8-bits and the 16-bit. Well, this is like a 3D version. So I'll start off in the tower. This is like basically a world select. Here I am. Now these ones that have got an open doorway you can go through, you have to unlock them later on. Go into the first world.
You are now entering the Valley of Fire.
The Valley of Fire is the first stage. Let's do this. It's loading up. Now, as you can see, the graphics are very nice, very detailed for the age. It's in like an almost like an isometric 3D, but it's like in proper 3D rendered, using a pair of VR to do it. So we keep going. A great orchestral soundtrack. Have some of that. So we keep going. Yeah, you can destroy the barrels like this, and the baddies will keep coming unless you destroy the generators. So I can go up these steps right here, because I've just opened the door with the key. Watch out for him. Ouch! have some of that. So we keep going. Ouch. Ouch. Have some of that. Yeah, you can have four players on this at once if you've got four controllers and four people to do so. I don't think you can have computer control players. Well, if you can, I'm not sure how to do it. So we keep going. Nice valiant effort on the Dreamcast right here. Nice way to start our show. Pick up the key. So you can use the key to open the doors and the chests. I'll open this chest right here. That's giving me 100 health. Watch out for these bombs. Someone's throwing them, it's that little green thing there. And we keep going. Pick up these hammers. So that's Gauntlet Legends on the Dreamcast. A brief look at it. I'm going to give it a nice 8 out of 10. Now, it's on to the next game. What will it be? Let's find out. We cross over to our next game, and it is, of course, it's Sega Rally 2 on the Dreamcast. So we start the game. Yeah, so we'll load up now. So we start the desert, just like on the first Sega Rally. This is based on the coin up machine, Sega Rally 2. So let's do this. 3, 2, 1, go! So this is Sega Rally 2 on the Sega Dreamcast. As you can see, it's very nice. Little bit of frame rate suffer on occasion, but other than that it seems perfectly playable. Not quite as fun in my opinion as the original on the Sega Saturn or the arcade, but still an arcade game. Graphics are good, as you can see. So, internal Furia. Woo! Yeehaw! So we keep going. I'm not very good at these games, to be honest. And we keep going. Oh dear. So I didn't do too well there, so I retired. I got 16th place. Didn't even make it to the end, so it's game over for the boss right here. Now loading, as you can see. Let's try practice, a course to practice, and we'll try mountain. You get all these other ones as well, but we'll try mountain. So let's do this. I'll just won't bother putting in my name, just put 5 dots. And we keep going. So mountain level. I apologise for the sound being slightly out of sync on this Sega Rally video. There's slight delay in encoding. But you get the general idea. So, we keep going. As you can see, the frame rate's slowing down a little bit more on this level, cause probably because there's a lot more, there's more going on the screen, like the trees and all that. So we keep going. And that's Tiger Rally 2 on the Tiger Dreamcast. I'm going to give it a respectable 7 out of 10. On to the next one. So this game, this next game is made by Sega Sports. Or Sega again. In conjunction with Inner Loop. Five DSL, I think that says. Funky sound by Ninja Tune. Okay. Specialized. Okay. And it is specialized. So it's loading up. Here we go. Have you guessed what game it is yet? You should have done by now. It is Sega Extreme Sports. As you can see, this is another 1999 game.
Championship.
So we're going to the championship. Let's have a look at Sega Extreme Sports right here. That's loud enough. Yeah, the only thing that's open is easy.
Choose your character.
So on first impression, we've got to choose our character. We get four to choose from, two girls and two boys. I'll be Noel.
Enter your name.
So I've got to enter my name. I'll just put AAA. So we keep going. So this is Sega Extreme Sports loading up right here. On the old Sega Dreamcast. So here it comes. So I'm starting off on the snowboard. Here we go.
One, go!
As you can see, the graphics are very nice, very smooth, very high up. Got a good draw distance. Ouch! That wasn't too good of a start. So I'm going down here on the snowboard. Music's okay. In third place at the moment.
Look out!
Oh, I've just bet him. I've just overtook him. So we keep going downhill. Talk about extreme sports. You can see that this is pure 128 bit power on the power VR. So we keep going. Checkpoint! It's pretty smooth, not much slower. Oh. And we keep going. So now I've got to get off my snowboard and go for the hang glider.
You're about 8 seconds behind.
So we keep going. I'm now flying on the hang glider, so there's some variety to the game. We're flying sky high. And we keep going. It's not the easiest thing to control. Not too difficult. Woo! Yeehaw! It says press red to release, but I think I was too late. So, I don't know. Ah, run out of time. So we keep going. I think, to be honest, I failed this because I think I was supposed to release.
You're getting low on time.
Getting low on time, so it's going to end.
You failed, man.
So I don't really want to do it, try again, so I'm just going to come off this. If I just press pause to go to quit. Yes, I'm sure. And we'll come out of this one. See if I can... So it does take a while to load. Not too long, it's not too bad.
Extreme Sports Championship.
We're having another look, but I think it's only easy that's unlocked at the moment. You've got to obviously win easy to unlock later ones. Yes, I can't choose anything else, so I'll give that 9 out of 10. So this one is, have you guessed it yet? It is dun 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 dun. It's my boy Capcom. So what's it gonna be?
Welcome to the Power Stone world.
It's Power Stone 2. I don't have Power Stone 1, so I've got Power Stone 2 though. So let's have a look at Power
Fight
Stone
for
2.
Your freedom. Escape from the castle.
So this is Power Stone 2 on the Sega Dreamcast. So first of all, I've got to choose a player. So you get to choose these 5 levels at the start. And here we go, let's do this. This is another one of them games where you can have 4 players at once.
A solid beginning may lead to a perfect ending. Go for it!
As you can see on the top of the screen, it says new challenger. And on to the right of it, when it comes on, it says press start button on all 3 players, so you can have 4 players at once. It's only me here, so that's what I'm going to be doing, just the 1 player.
Let the battle begin.
It says 2 will survive. Action! There we go. This is like organized chaos, or should I say disorganized chaos. But basically, it's a bit like a game where you've got to pick up anything you can find and throw it at the baddies. So we keep going. I'm the one that says 1P above me, which you can just about make out. I'm not very good at this at all. I'm not very good at most games, to be honest. So we keep going. To be honest, like flying machine. All the other players are being controlled by the computer or the Dreamcast. How we keep going? I don't know what's going on, to be honest. I can't find my sprite. Oh no! The vehicle's falling apart. How we keep going? Sorry about the slight slowdown there, it's not the Dreamcast, it's my video recording software. I'm using an easy cap in Windows 10. So we keep going. Excuse me for the cough. So we're falling down there. I've got an umbrella now, have some of that. Have that with my umbrella. Have some of that. Music's very good, graphics are nice, very smooth, very fast and friendly gameplay. True classic. Good Capcom quality. Oh, that one's got inside that vehicle. Oh no, I'm dead! Oh, you fuck!
Victory.
So the all 3 computers...
Try again.
I lost, let's give it another go.
Fight for your freedom! Escape from the castle.
So we keep going.
A solid beginning may lead to a perfect ending. Go for it.
Mm-hmm.
your step.
Oh, it didn't let me choose my level again. I'll have to do it if we go on the next one. Time on again. So we keep going. Have some of that. Have some of that. So we keep going. Have that. So yeah, the graphics are good, sounds good, it's really smooth. You can have it in either 50Hz or 60Hz mode. It gives you a choice when you first play the game. And yeah, so this is Hearthstone 2 on Sega Dreamcast. Still playable, very playable after all these years. So we keep going. Have some of that.
The sky is falling.
Oh no, here we go again. Falling down again. So we keep going. I've got the umbrella again. Have some of that. Oh, you fuck. Have some of that. Music's fantastic. So we keep going. Have some of that. Watch out for him right here. You can actually get into that vehicle, as the enemy has done. I'm not sure, quite sure how, but you can. So we keep going. So this is Hearthstone 2 on the Sega Dreamcast. I'm going to give it a fantastic 9 out of 10. Goodbye. It's not goodbye because it's on to the next game. Here it comes. So what's it going to be next? It's Hydro Thunder. So we have a look at the options right here. I'll just start the game. So this is going to be Hydro Thunder.
Choose your track, Thunder Park.
I'll go on Thunder Park, why not? Medium. So let's start the game and it will load up in a second.
Choose your boat.
I love that boat. Torpedoes. Damn the poor torpedoes! So it says, get ready to race Thunder Park. Finish easy in top 3 to race medium tracks. So we just wait for the game to load up and we shall start on Thunder Park. Here it comes.
3, 2, 1, go, go!
As you can see, this is like a boat racing game. So we keep going. So you can see the graphics are very good. Very arcadey, very nice looking. The music's pretty good as well. Controls are okay. They're not the best controls in the world, but they seem responsive enough. Very smooth, solid frame rate.
Time extended.
So we keep going. Oh shade, we keep going! Yes, use your booster. Well, you gotta collect these boosts. I don't think... I'm not sure how to do that. So, we keep going. But I know how to collect the boosts. You just walk... Well, not walk. You just ride into them. Oh, I missed that ramp then. I wanted to go up that ramp to get that boost. We keep going. Can hear the audience cheering. Here we go, it's a ramp. There we go, I've got the boost. 4 seconds.
Time extended.
Time extended. So we're on the final lap now. Watch out for this AI player right here. Have some of that. Keep going. So that was Hydro Thunder, the Sega Dreamcast version, and I'm going to give it a nice 8 out of 10. On to the next. Yes, that's right. Soul Calibur. Soul Blade 2, I think.
Namco.
So this is Soul Calibur.
Welcome back to the stage of history.
First job is to select the character that you want to be. I'll be Maxi. So this is obviously a beat 'em up.
Maxi versus Ivy. Battle 1. Fight!
Apologies about the slight frame skipping on this one. There was a few issues when recording the footage from the Dreamcast. But you get the general idea. A lot of videos are never perfect, as we all know. As I'm an amateur.
This victory strengthens the soul of
this sort of stuff.
You win! Battle 2, fight!
So this is Soul Calibur on Dreamcast, the graphics are amazing. For each day. It's not jerky like that on the actual console, this is just my video. So again, apologise. Windows 10 was doing something with the activity on the hard drive. Maybe, well, I don't know what it was doing, indexing or something, and it was causing a bit of slowdown. Well, anyway, so yeah, you get the general idea. The graphics are amazing. It doesn't look like it on the video, but the gameplay is extremely smooth. The music's wonderful. Very impressive. Very detailed, gorgeous graphics game, to be honest. This is Soul Calibur, and highly recommended if you like fighting games. So yeah, so if you've got a Dreamcast, I would definitely get this. Amazing. So that's Soul Calibur on the Dreamcast. There are many apologises for the stuttering on this particular clip. Well, there was some problem whilst recording, but anyway, that's Soul Calibur 9 out of 10. So, the next one is going to be... Yes, you've guessed it, Metropolis Street Racer. Later went as Project Gotham Racing on the Xbox, but this is the original Metropolis Street Racer on the Dreamcast. And you get a choice of cars. So let's do this. So basically, I won the challenge, just started the game, and I've got to try and beat the lap, the best lap. So let's try this, let's wait for it to load, and we'll try it. Here it comes, I'll be ready for this. Now as you can see, the graphics are pretty good, actually they're amazing. This is Metropolis Street Racer, and as you can see, graphics are good, really good. So we keep going. That wasn't good. I went straight into the wall right there. So we keep going. It's a really good game. It's really fun, playable. I'm not doing too well. If you look on the top left, my lap is at 55 and the target time is 33. Oh, that's not too good. So we keep going. Ouch. I'm absolutely terrible at this. So we keep going. See, you'll keep trying to do it until you get past that 33 target time. As soon as you get past that, then the mission is complete and you get the car. But to be honest, I'm not doing too well. Look, I'm already at 32 seconds now. I was 3 seconds out for that time. Because I keep crashing like that, that's why I'm not doing well, because I keep losing out the seconds by doing that. Sorry, keep going. Yeah, so this is Metropolis Street Racer right here. There's a lot more to the game. I'm only going to be looking at it briefly. I might do a full review of it on YouTube once I get all these stuttering problems sorted. This is a fantastic addition to your Dreamcast collection. Absolutely. If you like driving games, then I highly recommend it. Highly recommend it. If you don't like driving games. But anyway, so we keep going. No, Dan seems to be able to get to this lap, do I? I'm horrendous at this game, like I said. Need a lot more practice, to be honest. So we keep going.
ダンサークとドミネーターにインタビューすることになっています。これはもう見逃せませんよ。まだまだ5位にチャートインしているミスティをフューチャーしたカプリコン、承認用などを次にお送りしましょう。
Your seatbelts, guys. This is Red Line from Tomahawk.
So that is the conclusion to the Sega Dreamcast Special. It was fun making it. It took only a Sunday morning to make it, and a little bit of outdoor footage. And this is the end of the video. Now. Who says there won't be a part 2, I don't know.
We shall see.
Metropolis Street Racer is the way we're going to end this video, because Metropolis Street Racer is one of the highly recommended games on the Dreamcast. Now, I do realise that I haven't featured such classics such as Crazy Taxi, Sonic Adventure, Daytona, and other such Dreamcast classics, and the reason being, I don't own the games yet, so hopefully I will be buying them games, and hopefully they will be another video about those games. I'd like to thank everyone for watching, and it's been a pleasure doing the video. As you can see, I still haven't bet the target time. I'm absolutely rubbish at this game, but I definitely highly recommend it. So, Metropolis Street Racer, I'm going to leave you with 9 out of 10. Goodbye.